And good day, my wonderful students. I still remain myself, Teacher Yunus Olani. How was your weekend? Fine, I trust you. Now, for today's class in mathematics, we shall be looking at indices and its application. Say it, everybody. Indices and its application. Now, the topic outlines include meaning of indices. We shall be looking at the meaning of indices. Then, apart from that, we move to the relationship between standard form and indices, followed by the laws of indices and the application of laws of indices. Now, meaning of indices. Meaning of indices, as you can see it in the topic outline. Meaning of indices. When you say indices, now let me start with index. Then indices. Index is the singular form, while indices is the plural form. That is, when you have more than one index notation, you call it indices. That is the plural form of index form. Then, what is this indices all about? Indices refer to as an expression whereby one real number or variables or variable carries another real number or variable. Now, we are looking at this. We have some keywords here. The first one, real number, variable. Likewise, even an expression is one of the keywords here. An expression is when you have combination of letter and number in mathematics. For example, you can have something like 2x. 2x is an expression, whereby the 2 that is here is the coefficient of this variable x. X is called the variable. X is the variable, while the 2 here is the coefficient. When you now have the combination of the 2, you call it an expression. Now, real numbers. Real numbers, we have the counting numbers, integers. You are familiar with this. Numbers that we use in counting, 1, 2, 3, etc. Apart from that, we have whole numbers, we have decimal numbers. Now, let's move to the topic of the day. Meaning of indices. Indices refer to as an expression whereby one real number or variable carries another real number or variable. For example, e.g. When you look at this, let's say 5, then you have 3 on top. What do you notice? You will notice that the 5 here is bigger than this 3. 5 is a real number. 3 is also a real number, meaning that you can have a combination of real number and another real number. The one that is carrying another one, this one, the 5 that is here, carrying this 3, the 5 is called the base. Why the 3 up is called the power? You call it power or Exponents. Exponents. Now what do I call it? We have power of exponents. Or at times, we can also call it index. Index. We have the base and the power, or the exponent of index. In summary, indices is a combination of base and power. For you to have indices, there must be base and there must be power. For you to know that this is an index form, there must be the base, there must be the power. The base could either be a real number, it could be a variable. For example, another one is this. Based on the definition of the word, you can also have something like this. K raised to the power of 2. When you look at this, K here, which is our base, is a variable. Variable refers to letters in mathematics. Letters in mathematics. Letters of the alphabet. In mathematics, we call it variable. Like K now is a variable. Why the 2 here is an integer. An integer is a typical example of real number. Meaning that for us to have index notation or indices, we can have real number and real number, that is integer and integer. We can have what? Variable and what? And integer as well. This is also what? Indices as well. This is also written in index form, k raised to the power of 2. Now, another example. You can also have variable and variable. It is possible to have variable and variable. You can have something like m raised to the power of a. It's also in index form. The bottom line is just that you must have the base and the power. So please take note of that. For you to have index notation or indices, there must be the base and there must be the power. Now, in summary, indices is just a combination of the base and the power. Any question, please? Let's proceed. Let's proceed to relationship between standard form and indices. Standard form and indices. Now, in your previous class, you have learned standard form, and this is indices now. You have relationship between the two. Now, the general format for standard form, that is capital letter A multiplied by 10 raised to the power of n. If you can remember vividly, in your GSS 2 and GSS 3, you have learned this, that the standard form, this is the format, A multiplied by 10 raised to the power n. This A happens to be number between 1 and 10. But this one, we are looking at this, 10 raised to the power n. Who can tell me? What can you say about this? Relate this to what we have done so far. You will notice that by the definition of indices, I said is a combination of the base and the power. We are looking at this, 10 here is the base. Yn, small letter n here, is the power. Telling us that standard form cannot exist without index notation or without indices. Have I made myself clear? Telling us that part of standard form is what? Is index notation or indices, which is this 10 raised to the power of n. Any question, please? Now, let's now proceed. Now that we have asserted that there is a relationship between standard form and indices, for us to now apply or to make use of indices, there are rules govern the use of or the application of indices. The rule is what is being referred to as laws of indices. Say it, please. Laws of indices. Laws of indices. These are the laws or the rules that guide the use of indices as a topic. Now, law of indices, law one. Let's look at law one. Please, let's pay maximum attention. Law one. Law one is also known as multiplication law. Multiplication law. Multiplication law. That is law one, multiplication law. The law states that when you have index notation, let's say you have n raised to the power of a, you agree with me that this is index. This is index, that is index notation. Simply because m is the base, small letter a here is the power, telling us that this is index notation. Multiplied by another n, the raised to the power of b. Let's look at this. What do you notice? You will notice that the m here, which is the base, is still the same thing as the base here. So the law one, which is multiplication law, states that when you have the same base, the law states that you are going to copy one out of the base. You copy one out of the base, which is n. Copy one, that is to bring out one, then you now add the power. You add the power or the exponent or the index, that is a plus b. So this is law one. Example, 5 raised to the power 4 multiplied by 5 raised to the power of 2. Let's look at this. This, we have 5 is the base, 5 is the base here. Copy 1 out of the 5. Then in between the two indices, you have multiplication in between. That's why they call it multiplication law. When you have multiplication in between, you are going to add the power. That means you have 4 plus 2. The answer is now 5 raised to the power of 6. That's it. Let me give you one more example here. Example 2. Let's say x raised to the power minus 3 multiplied by x raised to the power minus 4. Something like this. Whether you have it in variable form or in numeric form, this one numeric form, this one variable form, apply that law. The same way, x is the base, x is the base, copy one out of the x. Minus 3 is the power here, write down minus 3. In between this one and this one, you have multiplication. Apply the multiplication law, which states that you have to add the power. That is plus, open bracket, minus 4. This will now be x raised to the power minus 3 plus times minus, minus 4. The answer is now x raised to the power minus 7. So that is just multiplication law of indices. Any question, please? Now, you will notice you should have asked me, what if we have something like this? We are still on multiplication law. What if we have something like this? 5 raised to the power of 2 multiplied by 2. Raised to the power of 2. Let's look at this. 5 is the base here. 2 is the base here. The difference between this one and this is that in example 1 here, the base are the same. Power differ. Here, base differ. Powers the same. Are we still going to apply the law of indices? The answer is yes. This is it. You are going to apply the same thing. Since here, it is the power or the exponent that are the same. You are going to copy one out of the power. That means what will give us? You are going to multiply this 5 and this 2. Normal multiplication. 5 multiplied by 2. Bracket open, bracket close. You now copy 1 out of the power. Since you have the same power, you copy 1. That is, bring out 1. This will now be 10 raised to the power of 2, which is 10 times 10, which is 100. If you want to confirm this, what is 5 squared? That's 5 times 5 in an expanded form. This gives us 25. What is 2 raised to the power of 2? That is 2 times 2 in an expanded form. This gives us 4. Then what is 25 multiplied by 4, which is equal to what? 100, which is the same thing as 10 raised to the power 2. Am I making sense at all? Fine. Telling us that when you have the same base, different power, we copy one out of the base. If you have the same power, different base, we copy one out of the power. But what if you have something like this? Before we now move to the next law, if you have something like 3 raised to the power 3 multiplied by 3 raised to the power 3 as well. You can see this. Very funny. Base the same, power the same. What are we going to do? In a situation like this, that you have the same base, the same power, you are going to make reference to the base. Please. Make reference to the base. Make reference to the base. Telling us that we have 3 here. Take one out of the base. But the power that is here, don't take one out of the power. We are going to add the power. 3 plus 3. This is 3 raised to the power 6. If you want to confirm that, what is 3 raised to the power 3? 3 times 3 times 3. That is 27. Multiply by 3 times 3 times 3 again. 27. By the time you multiply 27 by 27, we are going to get this 3 raised to the power 6 for sure. Have I made myself clear? So please take note of that. Very, very important. Now, let's proceed to law 2. Second law, which is law 2, that one is called division law. Division law. Division law of indices. Division law of indices. Division law of indices is almost the same thing as a multiplication law. The only difference is just that you are going to subtract the power. Unlike multiplication law, you have the power. Division law is subtract the power. Example. Let's say you have m raised to the power a divided by m raised to the power of b. This is the same thing as m raised to the power a over m raised to the power b. I so much believe that you understand it, that this one division is still the same thing as over m raised to the power a over m raised to the power b. This one, you are going to copy one out of the base. Copy one out of this. Then the power here is a. Then for the fact that you have division in between the two indices, you are going to subtract the power. That is a minus b. So this is division law. Division law. D2 for multiplication law. The same thing. The only difference is just that you subtract the power. All other things, the same thing. All things being equal. So any question, please? Now, let me give you an example here, e.g. 10 raised to the power minus 5 divided by 10 raised to the power of 4. This is just, you copy one out of the base, 10 minus 5, then this division returns to minus, then 4. This gives us what? 10 raised to the power minus 9. So that's division of indices. Any question, please, before we proceed? For multiplication law, you have the power. For division law, you subtract the power. That is just the difference between the two. All other things, the same. So please take note of that. Law 3. The law 3. The third law is called product power law. Product power law. Product power law. We call it product power law. Product power law. If you have something like x raised to the power a, then bracket, then b, you have this. When you look at this, you will notice that we have more than one exponent. We have more than one power. In this case, unlike the previous example, when we can, A is power, B is also what? Power. A base, just a base, carrying more than one power. That's why they name it product power law. When you have a base carrying more than one power, what you have to do is write that base out, then you multiply the power. Just multiply. Even if you have more than two, you can have like five powers. multiply everything together. That means A multiplied by B. The answer is now what? X raised to power A, B. Please take note of that. E.g. 5 raised to power minus 2, open bracket 3. This is 5 raised to power minus 2 times 3. This gives us 5 raised to power minus 6. So you have this. So please, any question? Product power law is when you have a base carrying more than one exponent or more than one power. It could be 2, it could be more than 2. It is possible. So please, what you have to do is just multiply the powers together. That's all. Then law 4. So let's keep it. Keep the law before the application. Law 4. Law 4. That is negative index law. Call it negative index law. Negative index law. That is law 4. Negative index law. Let me relate this last example in law 3. Let me relate it to law 4 now. What do you notice? If when you look at this, the solution here, which is 5 raised to the power minus 6, if I may ask, what do you notice? You will notice that the power here is a negative form, as you can see. That's why the name is negative index law. Anytime you have a negative power, negative index, negative exponent, you are going to apply that law. The law states that you are going to make reciprocal of that power. Make reciprocal. What does that mean? Reciprocal means 1 over, for example, now what is reciprocal of 2? The answer is 1 over 2. Now, make reciprocal. Turn this minus sign to reciprocal. 1 over then 5 raised to the power of 6. Simple as that. You call it negative index law. Another example, please. Let's say you have x raised to the power minus a. Something like this. This will give us 1 over x raised to the power a. Simple. Just make reciprocal of it. 1 over then x raised to the power a. The law is called negative index law. Any question, please, before I proceed? Law 5. Law 5. The fifth law is called fractional index law. Fractional index law. Fractional index law, from the name, fractional index. It's very simple. Fraction, meaning that the power must be a fraction for sure. E.g., let's say y raised to power 1 over a, something like this. Y raised to power 1 over a. Y is the base. 1 over a is the power or the index. But the power here is an index, is what? Is a fractional form, as you can see. Fraction, you must have what? Numerator and denominator. Meaning that the what? The power here is a fraction. The law states that the denominator will represent the root. Please take note of that. Will represent the root, while the numerator will represent the power. Please take note of that in indices. This one gives us, that is the answer to this one is root. Now I said denominator will represent the root. That means you are going to put a, eight roots. Denominator will represent the root, put the base inside that root. Why this one, the numerator will represent the power. That means bracket open, bracket close, raised to the power of 1, 7. Another example, please. Let me use number. Now, let's say x raised to the power 2 over 3. You are being asked to simplify this. This is an index form for sure because you have the base and the power. This will now be make the roots. Denominator will serve as the roots, meaning that cube roots. put the base inside the roots. Numerator will serve as the power. That means bracket open, bracket close, then square. So that's it. You call it fractional index law. Does that make any sense at all? It's when you have fraction as the power or fraction as the exponent. And don't forget, denominator will serve as the root. Numerator will serve as the power. Then the last law for the day, the last law of indices, the last law before we now move to the application, law 6, that one is called zero index law. Zero index law. Zero index law. Now what do I call it? Zero index law. From the name, zero index. Meaning that the power must be zero. That's the meaning. For example, e.g. m raised to the power of zero. The law states that anything raised to the power zero is one. Anything raised to the power zero is one. 10 raised to the power zero is one. Minus 5, bracket open, bracket close, raised to the power zero is one. But you should have asked me, what if you have 0 raised to the power of 0? Anybody? 0 raised to the power 0. I know that majority will say 1. 0 raised to the power 0 is not equal to 1, please. That's why I said anything raised to the power 0. 0 is nothing. 0 is nothing. So 0 raised to the power 0 will give us what? 0, please. Not the what? Not 1. Telling us that the base cannot be zero. Base of an index notation can never be zero, but the powers can be zero. Powers can be zero, but base can never be zero. So in summary, please, in summary, the law of indices, take note of this. Take note of this. For you to have index notation, also known as indices, there must be the base and there must be the power. There must be the base and there must be the power. Take note of that. Then for you to apply the law, the indices, there must be what? Laws or rules that we guide you in using indices or in applying indices. The law are called the laws of indices. We have the multiplication law, division law, we have the product power law, we have the fractional index law, we have the negative index law, and the zero index law. All these are the laws of indices. We now be using the laws of indices to solve problems. So that is what we now call application of indices. So any question before proceed? Now. Application of indices. Now, application of indices. Example 1. Simplify power of minus 5 multiplied by 10 raised to the power 2, then over 10 raised to the power of 7. Let's look at this. This is a typical example of application of indices. 10 raised to the power minus 5 multiplied by 10 raised to the power 2 over 10 raised to the power of 7. Now looking at this. For the numerator, the base are the same. 10, 10. Likewise, denominator, the same base as well. Meaning that we are going to apply two laws of indices here. Multiplication law and division law. That is law 1 and law 2. This is 10, 10. As you can see, the same base. Copy 1. Minus 5. In between this and this, you have multiplication. That means you have the power 2. over 10 raised to the power of 7. This is the same thing as 10 raised to the power minus 5 plus 2. Minus 5 plus 2, that is minus 3. Then over 10 raised to the power 7. Please, and then this is desist from canceling this 10 and this 10. The only condition that you can cancel in this list is when they are the same in no ramification. Meaning that, let us look here, you have 10 raised to the power minus 3. This one is also 10 raised to the power minus 3. You are free to cancel the numerator and the denominator. But since you have different powers, please do not cancel. You are going to apply the word, the second law of indices here. That means you have 10, 10, 10, 10, copy 1 out of the 2, minus 3, then division in between, the third to minus, then 7. This will now be 10 raised to the power minus 3 minus 7, that's minus 10. If I may ask, is this the final answer? I know some of you will say yes, and some will say no. This is not the final answer. We can still simplify this further by applying what? Anybody? That's good of you. We are going to apply negative index law. That's very correct. Because we can still simplify this. This one is a negative power. We now apply negative index law by finding reciprocal of this. That is 1 over the 10 raised to the power of 10. So this is the final answer. Or you can simplify this 10 raised to the power 10 as 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 in 10 places. You get your answer. Or you leave your answer like this. So this is the correct answer. 1 over 10 raised to the power of 10. So please look at this. You have any question? So please direct it. This one we apply both the first law and the second law. That is multiplication law and division law. Let me give you a second example before the class for example 2. Simplify part 2 raised to power 0.8. Simplify this. You might be wondering, how is it that we have a decimal power? I've said it earlier that the power could be integer, could be whole number, could be decimal, could be fraction, could be positive, could be negative. Now, it's very simple. This is 32 solution. 32 raised to the power 0.8. This is the same thing as 32. Then you change the 0.8, which is decimal. We change it to fraction form. It's very, very important. You have to change it. This is 8 over 10. You agree with me? 8 over 10. This is the same thing as 32. When you reduce this to lowest 10, 2 in 8, that is 4. Then 2 in 10, that is 5. That is 4 over 5. So you first change it like that. You now notice that we've changed the what? The decimal power. We've changed it to what? Fractional power. You now think of what? Fractional index law, very good. Fractional index law, which states that the root denominator will serve as the root, you put 5 here. 32, which is the base to the inside, then bracket open, bracket close. The numerator will now serve as the power, take note of that. But that is not the final answer. You have to get the fifth root of 32. Fifth root of 32. What does it mean? Fifth root of 32. That is a number that will repeat itself. A number that will repeat itself. A single number that will repeat itself five times that will give us this 32. If you agree with me, the answer is 2. For example, when you have 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2 times 2, 4. 4 times 2, 8. 8 times 2, 16. 16 times 2, 32. Telling us that fifth root of 32 is 2. As simple as that. That this one will just be 2, which is the fifth root of 32. Then the power raised to the power 4. This is the same thing now. 2 raised to the power 4. That's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is equals to 16. As simple as that. Please take note of that. Another alternatively, when you have 32 raised to the power 4 over 5, you can quickly change this 32 to index form. 32 to index form is 2 raised to the power of 5. Do you agree with me? 2 raised to the power of 5, another power 4 over 5. Telling us that mathematics is not limited to just one method. I can apply another rule here, another law, which is what? Product power law, and still arrive at the same answer. This one, I applied what? Fractional index law. I want to use product power law now. This will now be 2 raised to the power 5 times 4 over 5, as you can see. So the 5 here is going to cancel this 5. This will now be 2 raised to the power of 4, which is the same thing as 16, as simple as that. So, let me now give you class work. The class work based on what we've done so far. Class exercise. Simplify the following. Raised to power x plus 1. 2. That's 2 questions. 16 raised to power 3 over 4 times 2 raised to power minus 3 multiplied by 5 raised to power of 0. So that's the class work. So you have to submit the classwork to the mail. You can also use it as assignments. Submit it to this mail. Olani808@gmail.com. And don't forget to copy this. Training at edu.ng. training@edu.ng. Once again, the classwork or the assignments, forward the assignments or the classwork to the email above. Alani808@gmail.com and copy this. Copy training@edu.ng. This will now bring us to the end of the class. Any question, please? So have a wonderful day and make yourself available. Next class, we'll be looking at further application of indices and algorithms, and the further application of indices as well as indicator equations. So good day, class.